transcribed.
Hey, Dean. Dean, look at my new shirt.
Hey, nice material, Jerry. Good fit, too.
Yeah, and at night it lights up and spells Chesterfield.
Well, how about that? But why don't you tuck your shirt tail in? It's so long.
Oh, well, in front, my shirt is regular size, and in back, it's king size. Over a fifth longer.
Which means the Chesterfield, first with premium quality and best for you, brings you the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Chesterfield is best for you. Much milder, better tasting too. They're today's best cigarette buy.
Come on, smokers, why don't you try
Chesterfield,
best for you.
Chesterfield,
best for you.
Regular, king size, either way. Make it Chesterfield today.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to bring you our master of ceremonies, Dean Martin.
Thank you. Well, it's time for another Chesterfield meeting to come to order. There's lots of laughter and music on the agenda for tonight, and as soon as I pick up my trusty gavel and rap on my partner Jerry's wooden head, the business will begin. So, Richard, if you're ready to move your baton, I'll be happy to second the motion.
I love you twice as much, twice as much as you say I do. I want you twice as much, twice as much. I'll try to prove to you I'll do twice as much. All of my life to make your life a happy one. I'll build you up now, let you down, you'll be the most loved gal in town. 'Cause that's how I love you, twice as much. Down, you'll be the most loved gal in town. 'Cause that's how I love you, twice as much.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You know, lots of people ask me if success has gone to my partner's head. Well, it hasn't. Even though Jerry can afford a chauffeur, he drives himself. Even though he can afford to go to a barber, he shaves himself. And today, he's the happiest guy in the world.
I just learned how to dress myself.
Well, heavens to that, it's Jerry Lewis! Well, what's the matter, Jerry? You look kind of serious today.
I'm glad you recognized it, Dean. I do have a serious announcement to make. Ladies and gentlemen, before Dean and I start cutting up, I'd like to remind you that starting Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, animal lovers everywhere are celebrating National Be Kind to Worm Week. Yes, my dear listeners, remember, the next time you eat an apple, please be careful. You may be biting into a friend.
Jerry's right. In this case, half a friend is worse than none.
Dean, please restrain your levity. This is quite important. Friends, when you go fishing and you put the worm on the hook, also put on a lit candle. Who knows? It may be some little fishy's birthday.
Oh, Jerry. Now, why don't you stop with wasting time with that stuff. You find the strangest pets to worry about.
Maybe so, but I'm certainly worried about Lydia.
Who's Lydia? Who's Lydia?
My pet centipede. And Dean, she's expecting.
You mean...
Yes, any day now she's gonna have another leg.
Oh. Well, I hope she wears it in good health. Jerry, we've got a show to do. Why didn't you show up for rehearsal?
I was at my lawyer's. I spent 3 hours making out my won't.
Your won't? You mean you made out your will?
No, my won't. This is a list of people that won't get nothing.
Oh, and whom are you wanting out of your will?
My father, for making me go without supper.
That's no reason. Lots of fathers make their kids go without supper.
For 9 years?
No. 9 years without supper?
Yes, every night he used to give me a dime for going to bed without supper, and I put it under my pillow.
You did?
Yeah, but every night while I was asleep, he would make some excuse to Mother and tiptoe up to my room.
And your daddy had a change of heart. He brought you food.
No, he swiped the dime.
No!
And in the morning, he made me go without breakfast for losing the money.
Just you wait a minute. There's one thing I don't understand. Jay, how did your mother permit you to go without your supper for so long?
Oh, she didn't, Dean. In the middle of the night, she used to sneak into my room and leave a bowl of fruit.
And you ate the fruit?
That I did, and it was delicious. The finest wax I ever tasted.
You ate wax fruit? Didn't it make you sick?
No, but every once in a while, my face used to break out.
In rashes?
No, candles.
Oh. Well, at least your mother had good intentions. I hope you're not cutting her out of your won't.
Hardly. I'm leaving Mom my most valuable possession, my pearl-handled letter opener. I never used it.
Why not?
No one ever sent me any pearl-handled letters.
But are you really leaving nothing to your father in your will?
You don't understand, Dean. Daddy has warehouses in every major city in the country.
What does he keep in these warehouses?
Chicken fat.
Chicken fat?
Someday Dad's going to be rich.
Oh, whom does he plan to sell all this chicken fat to?
Skinny Chicken!
Well, obviously, your father needs nothing from you. He's the Howard Hughes of the chicken fat business.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave most of my money to my sister, Seal.
You have a sister, Seal?
We just call her Seal for short. Her whole name is Imbecile.
Sounds like Seal could use some of your father's chicken fat there.
Well, Seal deserves a break. Seal really deserves a break. If you knew Seal, you'd agree. She deserves a break. She's had oodles of trouble. You see, her husband spent 20 years building a boat in an aspirin bottle, and when he finally finished...
Yeah?
He couldn't get out.
But, despite all this trouble, Seal was brave. Hmm?
Yeah, she kept a stiff upper lip.
She did?
She had to. She had teeth like a walrus.
Tell me, Jerry, why did you suddenly decide to make out your will? Don't you feel well?
Oh, I feel sterling, positively sterling.
Then why did you go to your lawyers all of a sudden?
Dean Martin, haven't you seen today's paper?
No, why?
Well, there was a big article that the world's coming to an end in 5 million years.
Why'd you make out your will today?
I'm not one who waits till the last minute.
Here is Chesterfield's record with smokers. And important to you.
No adverse effects to the nose, throat, and sinuses from smoking Chesterfield.
That's the report of a doctor who has been examining a group of Chesterfield smokers for a full year and 2 months as a part of a program supervised by a responsible independent research laboratory. Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this? Chesterfield. First with premium quality. Chesterfield. First choice of young America. And that's from a survey made in 274 colleges and universities. Try Chesterfield's today. Chesterfield, regular or king size. They're much milder and best for you.
Well, friends, from the very first day that our picture, The Stooge, went into production, I considered myself fortunate to have had such a wonderful variety of songs to do in it. Since then, I've sung these tunes many, many times. But here's one I still haven't had a chance to do on the air. So tonight's the night.
The world looks rosy up on Sweetheart Hill. For a girl named May and a boy named Bill. Come on, get cozy, says the whippoorwill, to a girl named May and a boy. Where there's a sky that's full of moonlight and a Mary full of charm, there ought to be a William snuggled in her arms. So if I kiss you and I think I will, believe me, it's the only thing to do. For you're my Mary and I'm your Bill. And it's wonderful to be in love with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, by the way, our picture of the Stooge is still playing all over the country.
Yeah, and I want to thank everybody who wrote telling us how much they enjoyed it.
Yeah, do that.
Okay, thanks, Ma.
Of course, if you haven't seen the picture, it's still not too late.
Oh, it's hardly too late. In Africa, it's playing at the Lois Tarzan. The reservation's called 1346.
Oh, Jerry, please.
In Alaska, it may still be seen at Fox's Igloo. It's a drive-in theater. Dogs admitted free if accompanied by a sled.
Oh, Jerry.
So if you want to see the picture, mush on down. On the way in, pick up a bag of hot buttered blubber.
Please, Jerry, I'm trying to tell the audience that due to the success of the Stooges, we decided to produce our own picture. Of course, that requires a lot of money.
Oh, our troubles are over, Dean. Is that clear? I talked to a friend of mine, and he gave me this check for $10 million.
Oh, but, Jerry, the signature on this check isn't very clear.
Naturally, it ain't easy to write when you're wearing a straitjacket.
Well, the bankers told me that there'll be no problem getting the money for the picture if we sign up a leading lady with lots of experience.
I've got just that one, Dean, my girl. I discussed the entire matter with her last night when we were parked up on Ocean Drive.
Does she have experience?
She does now.
Oh.
Yeah, I think my choice for the part is a better one. And I've invited her here tonight to discuss the picture. Ladies and gentlemen, there are some artists whose performances you can never forget. They make a big part bigger and a small role outstanding. Such an artist is our guest this evening. She's capable, she's talented, she's a director's dream, Miss Phyllis Thaxter.
Thank you, Mr. Martin.
Oh, it's our pleasure to have you here, Miss Thaxter. I'd like you to meet my partner, Mr. Lewis.
Oh, Mr. Lewis. I think I've seen you before. Was it in Switzerland skiing or the Riviera yachting?
No, it was out in the alley spitting.
Jerry, you're talking to a very refined and important young lady. Miss Thaxter happens to be listed in the book Who's Who.
Big deal. It so happens that I got my name in a certain book, too.
What's that?
You guessed it.
Don't mind him, Miss Thaxley. You see, success has turned his hair.
I thought he had it on backwards.
Yes.
See here, Miss Thaxter, I resent that. Is that clear? Resent it, resent it. I resent it. Oh, do I resent that? Take another look. It just so happens my head is on perfectly straight.
Sorry.
My body's on backwards.
Oh, hush, Jerry. Phyllis, Phyllis. Jerry and I would like to have you in the 3D picture we're producing.
Yeah, we're using the curved screen.
But why did you pick me?
We wanted a curved girl.
Yeah.
Well, that's very flattering, but my figure is only run-of-the-mill.
Well, I sure'd like to be the guy who runs that mill.
About that picture, fellas, before we go any further, I'd like to know what the story is.
Oh, it's a great story. Jerry wrote it himself.
Yes, Miss Thaxter. It's the story of a man lawyer who's in love with a woman lawyer. And they live at her father's house, and he's also a lawyer. Another lady tries to break them up. She's a lawyer. But a lawyer friend of theirs straightens out the whole thing, and they have 3 children who all grow up to be lawyers.
What's the name of the picture?
Young Dr. Malone.
In this picture, I played a part of a handsome accountant. Women go crazy for me, but I toss them aside.
In this picture, who gets me?
I do.
How come?
I watch what side he tosses them.
That sounds most intriguing. Fellas, I might be interested in working with you if you had a truly dramatic story when I can really tear people's hearts out.
Oh, you're in luck, Phyllis. We've just got such a story for tonight. Fenneman?
Yes, Dean?
Start tearing the people's hearts out.
All right, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes?
The Chesterfield, gosh, they're peachy keen players, present Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Phyllis Thaxter in a stark drama that they dared Hollywood to make. It is the pitiful tale of a paroled convict, an ex-murderer, who couldn't hold a job because of his one little mistake. A man who in desperation was driven to drink. Entitled...
I'm a convict. My number's 9999. It's really 6666, but I like to walk around on my hands.
I'm Mrs. 9999. I haven't seen my husband in 30 years. I'm 27 years old. I married very young.
I'm a cellmate. All day long, I lie in my upper bunk and dream of getting out. And it ain't easy. There is no upper bunk.
I can't stand this prison any longer. All I ever serve is this coffee, coffee, coffee.
What's so bad about that?
No spoons. I'm going stir crazy.
You sure must be anxious to get out of here, kiddo. For the last 6 years, you've been marking off the days on that calendar.
Yeah, and time sure drags.
Why, what day is it today?
The 14th of Marilyn Monroe.
Kid, listen to me. We'll break out of here. I'll take you into my mob. You heard of the famous purple gang that hijacks booze?
You're with them?
No, I'm with the green gang.
The green gang? What do they hijack?
Chlorophyll.
No, breaking out, that's not for me. Today I'm going home. Home to my Mary. Mary.
John.
Mary.
John.
John.
Mary.
Neither of us had changed. We were still crazy, mixed-up kids. Mary?
Yes, John.
I haven't seen you in 70 years, and somehow you look different.
In what way, John?
You're wearing a new dress. Right?
No, John. It's the same one I've been wearing for 70 years.
Well, if you won't change it, at least dust it. It's very unsanitary.
John, you're home at last. Come, sit here next to me.
Ah, Mary, it's nice sitting in the same old living room in front of the same old roaring fire.
Yes, it is.
You know, sometimes I wish we had a fireplace.
John, you will go straight now, won't you? You won't go back to your evil companion.
No, I'll never go back to my evil companion. Who is it?
It is I, your evil companion.
Come in, Eve. Pam?
I came here to take you into the mob like I promised. We've just gone into the cold car racket.
You mean the hot car racket.
Oh, Cole, we steal good humor trucks.
No, no, no. Is that clear?
Kid, you're coming with our mob, and we ain't taking no for an answer. You remember Rocky tried saying no, and he was taken down to the winery and pushed into the wine press?
Poor Rocky, he's gone.
Yeah, you'll find him at your market, listed under Muscatel.
All grapes of wrath.
You'll never get away from me, pal. I'll follow you, trail your track, get down, you old hound dog. Never let you have a minute's peace. Gee, I'm such a fink.
Mary, it's no use. The mob will never let me alone. They'll hound me, hound me, hound me. Is that clear? Just like they hounded Muggsy, Lefty, Blackie, Wheelie, Turby, and Stavey. Just like they hounded Sam Middledorfer.
Who's Sam Middledorfer?
The kid in the parking lot. If I mention his name on the air, he don't scratch my fenders. Yellow!
Hello, John. This is the parole officer. I called to wish you a happy birthday.
There you go. Hounding me, hounding me, hounding, hounding.
But I only wanted to wish you a happy birthday.
I know, but I hound so easily.
Buddy, throw in with us and you won't have to live in a dump like this. Look, there's a hole in the roof and the rain is leaking in.
Oh, a plumber can fix that tomorrow.
And there's a leak in the sink. The water's dripping through.
Oh, a plumber can fix that tomorrow.
See, pal, your poor wife's crying. The tears are rolling down her cheeks.
Looks like the plumber's gonna have a big day tomorrow.
No more stalling, kid. You're coming with us, or I'll use my little persuader.
Pal, put down that revolver.
None done, chum. Now where do you want the bullet?
Does it make any difference to you?
No.
Then leave it in a gun.
Only if you come with us.
No, John. Before I see you become a fink again, I'd rather you were back in jail.
I won't go back to jail. Never, never, never. Is that clear? Never. Never go back. I won't.
Why not?
Never, never. Two more. Never.
Why not?
Because they hound me. Hound me. Always hound me. Hound me. They hound me. Is that clear?
Man, when he gets a hold of the line, he never lets go.
But, John, prison couldn't be that bad. You wrote that you had a good job in jail as a warden chauffeur.
Good job, Pa. I couldn't stand being a warden chauffeur. When he wanted to go to town, I had to take him. When he wanted to go to Washington, I had to take him. On his vacation, when he wanted to travel around the country, I had to take him.
What's so bad about that?
He didn't have a car. I carried him piggyback.
Years ahead of them all.
Chesterfield is years ahead of all cigarettes.
Chesterfield quality is highest. Here's the proof.
Recent chemical analyses give an index of good quality for the country's six leading cigarette brands. The index of good quality table, which is a ratio of high sugar to low nicotine, shows Chesterfield quality highest.
Chesterfield quality highest.
15% higher than its nearest competitor.
Chesterfield quality highest.
31% higher than the average of the five other leading brands. Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this?
Chesterfield, first with premium quality and best for you.
Try Chesterfield today, regular or king size.
You know, this is my weekly opportunity to reach into the past for a good old song. So here's a good old goody that I hope you all remember and will like to hear again.
You always hurt the one that you love, the one you shouldn't hurt at all. You always take the sweetest rose and crush it till the petals fall. You always break the kindest heart with a hasty word you can't recall. So if I broke your heart last night, it's because I love you most of all. You always hurt the one that you love, the one you shouldn't hurt at all. You always take, oh, the sweetest kind of rose and crush it till the petals begin to fall. You always break the kindest heart with a hasty word you cannot recall. So if I broke your heart last night, it's because I love you most of all.
Deserve that applause, Dean. You know, you have a certain something that very few men have.
Well, thanks, Phyllis. You hear that, Jim?
Big deal. I once danced with Rita Hayworth, and she told me that she had been out with a lot of men, but I had a certain something that none of them had.
Really, Jerry?
Yeah. Dean?
Yes, Jerry?
What's asthma?
Look, Jerry, stop telling people you got asthma.
But I have. I also have bronchitis, pruritus, rheumatism, and beriberi. I'm very healthy.
Well, before I catch some of your health, I'd better get out of here.
Well, Phyllis, we can't let you go before we get a chance to tell you how nice it was to have you with us.
Yes, many, many thanks for being such a charming guest and such a good sport. Please ring our doorbell again soon, Phyllis.
That I will. And good night, Dean and Jerry. Good night, all.
Good night,
good night, Phyllis. Hey, folks, a week from this Sunday is Father's Day.
That's when you give Dad something to show him you think he's a pretty nice guy. And if you want to give him the best, give him premium quality Chesterfields in the red and white Father's Day carton.
You'll be giving him a gift of premium quality, and you'll also be giving him the cigarette that's best for him.
Don't just give him any cigarette, folks. Make it premium quality Chesterfield for Dad on Father's Day.
So until next week, this is Dean Martin.
And this is Jerry Lewis saying good night, everybody.
Good night, all.
From Hollywood, you've just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Produced and directed by Dick Mack. Written by Arthur Phillips and Austin Kalish. With music prepared and conducted by Dick Stabile. And this is George Fenneman reminding you to listen to Chesterfield's award-winning show, Dragnet, Sunday night on this same NBC station.
Have you tried new cork-tipped Fatima? It's the smooth smoke. Here's why. New Fatima tips of perfect cork. King size for longer filtering, and Fatima quality for a much better flavor and aroma. Remember, Fatima has the tip for your lips. Try new Fatima. See how smooth it is. Fatima is made by the makers of Chesterfield, Liggett and Myers, one of tobacco's most respected names.
Tonight, visit Fibber, McGee, and Molly on NBC.